Yes. Welcome back. I'm Alfred Lamrot Weber, and we're very privileged today to be with Kevin Annett, who is the field secretary for North America for the International Tribunal into Crimes of Church and State. Welcome, Kevin.
Hello, Alfred.
I understand that today we have some very important breaking news that affects us not only here in Canada, but indeed, world level breaking news.
We certainly do. This is one of our biggest announcements, literally in months. In a nutshell, we received information this last week that a member of Stephen Harper's cabinet, that's Prime Minister Stephen Harper in Canada, a member of his cabinet, a man called Denis Lebel, who is the minister for resources in Quebec. He's in the Privy Council, and he's the senior Quebec cabinet minister. We have information that Denis Lebel was present at a Ninth Circle ritual sacrifice in Rome on February 22nd. He was accompanied by this man, Gérald Lacroix, who was made a cardinal on that same day by Pope Francis, Jorge Bergoglio. He was the primate for the Catholic Church in Quebec. He was made a cardinal that day. He was accompanied to Rome by Denis Lebel, who's seen here with Jorge Bergoglio, the Pope. An official Canadian delegation went to Rome to see Gérald Lacroix made a cardinal. That same night, at midnight, the two men and others were present at a Ninth Circle sacrificial cult killing of a 5 or 6 year old boy. In this church. It's actually next to the Superior General Headquarters of the Jesuits. That's in Rome. You see the Vatican City in the background. That's the headquarters for the Jesuits. Right across the street is this San Lorenzo Posibus Church. And in the crypt here, and there's a picture of the crypt, that's in fact the altar we believe the child was killed on. And that's Pope Benedict performing a mass at the altar a few years ago. A child was killed at midnight, February 22nd, 2014, where Denis Lebel, Quebec cabinet minister, and Gérald Lacroix, cardinal from Quebec, were both present. Now, the reason, and let me just put this in a bigger context, we believe that we know from Anne-Marie von Bellenberg and others who have been present at Ninth Circle cult sacrifices that the Ninth Circle and the Drangheta criminal syndicate that provides the children and others for these rituals, they will often bring politicians and judges to these events, telling them that it's another event, telling them, for example, it's a reception or an important meeting they're to come to. Once the politician or judge is there, they're entrapped, and they're used by the Drangheta and the others after that. We believe, to give Denis Lebel the benefit of the doubt, we believe Denis Lebel was entrapped, unless, of course, he was a member of the Ninth Circle before that. That is a possibility, but we're assuming a man is innocent until proven guilty. He was entrapped at that meeting as a way to control the Harper cabinet. Now, it gets even more interesting because this information was made known to the ITCCS the very same week that this man was killed in Ottawa. We talked about this in previous broadcasts. Kel Gadban was an inspector with the Ottawa police. He was responsible for the human trafficking unit, and he had helped the disruption of the Ninth Circle cult ritual that was to sacrifice two children in Montreal on August 15th. You remember a special unit disrupted that, and they did so with information provided by Kel Gadban. He died in the Ottawa police station the same week that this information was made known about Denis Lebel and Gérald Lacroix being at that ritual in Rome. We believe he was killed because he knew that Harper cabinet minister was involved, and he was prepared to press charges and at least bring this up publicly, which would have created a scandal that clearly would have brought down the Harper government, that a member of his cabinet, a senior member, was involved, present at the ritual killing of a child in Rome, a Ninth Circle ritual. Now, the other thing about Gérald Lacroix is he's a member of a thing called the St. Pius X Society, which is a right-wing cult within the Catholic Church tied to the Argentine military dictatorship, a long history of being friends with neo-Nazi groups around the world. Jorge Bergoglio is trying to bring the Pius X Society back into the fold. And Girolacqua is a member of this cult. So there's that Vatican politics going on as well. So this ties together the reason for the false flag operation in Ottawa. We believe the shooting of that soldier in Ottawa, so-called shooting, was a staged event to distract, a huge distraction event away from this news that was about to break that implicated Harper's own cabinet minister in these Ninth Circle killings.
Yes, and so could you talk again about the connections between the Ninth Circle events that were disrupted by ITCCS in Montreal and in Quebec and this newest series of Ninth Circle events involving a Quebec-based now cardinal and a Quebec-based cabinet member, just to cement that relationship?
Well, there's a number of ties happening here. First of all, there's to cover the fact that the Ninth Circle is operating in a big way in Montreal. We've known that for a number of years. The Catholic Church, of course, tied into the Project Paperclip importing of a lot of Nazis through Quebec after the war, through the Dominicans and the Catholic Church, the kind of Nazi connection with the Pius X Society. But also the connection with Denis Lebel is interesting. Denis Lebel is a real political animal. He's been in the Parti Québécois, in the Liberals, and now he's in the Tories. He's a real survivor in Quebec politics. He's the minister responsible for resource development in Quebec. Now, we know from previous interviews that the Ninth Circle has as its members corporate executives in Cargill, in Sunoco, in a number of the large resource companies. There seems to be a connection there between human trafficking, child sacrifice, these big resource multinationals. So again, it could be a way to control this cabinet minister to get what they need out of him and the Harper government. But of course, the disruption of that Ninth Circle event on August 15th, the stopping of it and the identification of the Ninth Circle operating in Montreal sent shockwaves through the system of this criminal syndicate providing children. Clearly, this is a way, for the same reason they killed Cal Gadbrand, the Ottawa policeman, they had to tie up all the loose ends. And it's pretty clear now that the Harper government had a stake in tying up this loose end because it would seriously cost them the next election.
Now, this news is now becoming public. And so what reaction do you think will happen within the Harper cabinet, because of course they cannot stand this type of public revelation that not only within large corporations, not only within the churches, but within the political parties, namely the Conservative Party cabinet, we now have ritual slayings, members of the Ninth Circle.
Well, I mean, they're going to do what they always do. The Canadian government has done this all along. When we brought out the hard evidence of genocide in Canada of over 50,000 children killed, the government initially doesn't even comment. But eventually they can't deny it, because you notice the newspapers over the last number of months in Canada have begun to acknowledge it. Yes, tens of thousands of children died. So they eventually acknowledge things, but in a way to make it look like that they disclosed it. The same thing will happen here. They won't comment directly on this, but they're eventually going to come around to some kind of acknowledgement. They have to, at all costs, keep this out of the media, though. They know potentially what a field day the Liberals and the NDP will make out of this, because politically, if Denis Lebel is taken out, so are the Tory hopes in Quebec. They're running third in Quebec after the Liberals and fourth after the Liberals, the NDP, and the Bloc Québécois. The Tories are running very low in Quebec, and they need Denis Lebel in a big way. So this is politically disastrous for them. This gets out. I predict they'll just try to bury the story, bury us as much as possible, with the usual kind of smear and disinformation tactics all over the media. You can expect that to be coming out about us over the next while as well. But I mean, you know, our general theme here is that literally there's criminals and psychopaths in power, in government, in church, in the corporations. This is just more proof of it, Alfred, documented. And I should add this is coming from a number of sources. A journalist contact in Rome who has insider contact with the Jesuits and politicians in the Chamber of Deputies there who have confirmed this. We've got this confirmed through Ottawa police contact and Interpol and European Parliament members. They're all confirming this information about Jerome Lacroix and Denis Labelle.
Now, you had said that this information, that the ITCCS is opening an inquiry on this information. Generally, what follows is that once it is totally verified and there is a proceeding, generally some sort of a judgment and warrants, for example, an arrest warrant comes out. Do you anticipate that that is sort of the type of proceeding that will be followed here?
Absolutely, Alfred. As a matter of fact, it's got to happen that way in a very professional way. This is so important that it can't be bungled. We have, for example, in the second case we did into the child trafficking involving the present Pope, Jorge Bergoglio, a lot of that evidence is still being sat on because it's part of the ongoing inquiry. But we are putting together as much of that evidence as possible, and we'll be releasing it in a way that shows that a bona fide court procedure was involved, either through reenactment or in a way to show the evidence to the world. We have to do that even more effectively in this case because it's naming big-time actors now, and it's tying together the Canadian government, Drangheta, the Vatican, these large resource multinationals, all of the actors historically involved in genocide and now in child trafficking.
So if there is a judicial finding of probable cause found here, and if there is arrest warrants issued here, would then enforcement personnel of the ITCCS take action against a cabinet member of the Harper cabinet? Is that
in this case, we would not only rely on citizen arrests and the means that we've been advocating. We haven't been too successful in it because not a lot of people have been stepping up to the plate. People still do not believe they have the authority as men and women, as sovereign men and women, to take this action in their communities. We will be demanding official action on this. We will be looking to elements who are sympathetic within the police department to make these arrests. Of course, if they don't make the arrest, we'll be taking that action ourselves. But we are standing on such solid evidence with this, and it's involving such high-powered people, that we expect the police and elements in the government and that to respond to this, the honest elements in that system who do want to see justice done. So we're going to be making approaches on all these levels.
Yes, and if there are people who are watching this video who have information about this case or about other cases, how can they get in touch with the ITCCS?
Well, the main email, of course, is itccscentral@gmail.com, the website itccs.org. In this case, it's important, though, to realize that, you know, when we did the takedown on August 15th, we had a lot of people in Montreal writing to us saying, how can I take part? The reality is, if you're not a trained professional, you can't really take part in that level of operation. We need, and we brought in trained professionals to disrupt that killing of two children on August 15th. The best thing people can do is publicize this widely. This interview today needs to go viral all over the planet and all over Canada, and used as a means to prompt people to, for example, in Canada, be involved in the founding convention of the Republic of Canada on January 1st to 4th in Winnipeg, where these criminal actions of the Crown, which have been proved time and again, will compel people to set up a new political arrangement, a new constitutional arrangement of a republic that can initiate these common law courts and proceedings against these criminals in power. That's the kind of action people need to be doing on the ground, and we need many people involved in doing that. Let me emphasize another point here that actually we missed in the presentation. This event that happened in Rome is involving the Pope and cardinals. We know, for example, and here's a quote actually from one of the witnesses in Rome. Quote, "This isn't the first child sacrifice at San Lorenzo Church. It's right next door to the Jesuit Superior General's office." Now, don't forget, the Jesuit Superior General Adolphe Pichon announced his resignation after he had been named in the indictment in our last court case. He is stepping down as Jesuit leader. These sacrifices happen especially in February. February 21st and 22nd are the ancient Roman festivals of Ferelia and Terminalia, when animals and children were sacrificed in memory of the dead, unquote. Now, in other words, these child sacrifices in Rome go back thousands of years. They're happening on traditional Roman sacrificial events. And the 22nd of the month, of course, has been figured in a number of false flag operations. Don't forget, Denis Lebel has an official Canadian government delegation to Rome, and he makes these statements. Canada is proud that Gerard Lacroix is now a cardinal, cozying right up to the Vatican. The event happens, the ordination on the 22nd of February. That night, they're all present at the sacrifice of a 5 to 6 year old child who was anally and serially raped and then murdered, according to this witness. Now, in other words, this is part of this whole bigger system at work in Rome that reaches to Quebec. It reaches into the Canadian cabinet, the Canadian government cabinet. So this is something that people have to set up and take very seriously.
Right. What greater implications do you see for this case now, for this new offensive that the ITCCS is taking, and for your new plans?
Well, in our last interview, Alfred, we talked a lot about the need to shift from simple adjudication of these crimes into community action, to stopping the criminals on the ground. There's no case that illustrates this better. If the police do not take action, citizens in Denis Lebel's riding have to hold him accountable. They have to perform the citizen's arrests and bring him into a court where he can answer these questions, where he can say, were you present at this? Are you a member of the Ninth Circle cult? Are you being blackmailed by the Ninth Circle and Drangheta and the Vatican to do what they want, as they do all over the world and all over Europe? These hard questions have to be put, but in a way that has a repercussion. So we need people to step forward now and do the citizen sheriff training. Contact us, itccscentral@gmail.com. Help us here in Canada to stop the authority of the Crown, because if we don't, these kinds of murders are going to keep going on. It shows that Canadian government cabinet ministers feel they have the wherewithal to go over to Rome and take part in these murderous events, knowing they'll get away with it. And frankly, they have gotten away with it for many years, but our announcement now is that we're going to stop this. And for the sake of the children, for the sake of everybody in the world who is a decent human being who cares about justice.
Well, thank you. Are there any other issues or points that you'd like to bring up at this stage?
Well, you know, I want to express especially the an appeal to the family of Cal Gabin, the Ottawa policeman, who they claim killed himself after an incident on September 28th in the Ottawa police station. The incident they don't describe is the fact that he was assaulted and killed there. We know there's elements in the Ottawa police that are, like in Montreal, are on the payroll of Drangheta, the mafia. We also know there's elements that don't like what's going on, and we're appealing to those elements and to Cal Gabin's family to demand an inquiry into the real cause of his death. We will be working with anyone who wants to help us on that. And this issue is not going to go away. We are planning protests. We're planning public meetings in Ottawa over the next number of months on this issue. We're going to take and put it right in the face of the Harper government. We're appealing to all activists in Canada to take this seriously, to look at the crimes happening in your own backyard and not just in Iraq and Afghanistan, but bring it home now that the evidence has come out of the criminal complicity of the Harper government in these crimes.
Thank you. Do you have any final words that you'd like to leave our viewers with?
Well, you know, a lot of people recently have been saying to me, you know, you got to play it safe now, Kevin. Your life and the life of all of these other people is on the line now that you're going after Drangheta, especially. They have put out declared hits on members of the ITCS leadership, including myself. I beg to disagree with those people. Now is not the time to hide. Now is not the time to give in to the inevitable smear campaigns that are going to be raising their heads again. We've already gotten some indication that that started, aimed at myself and others. These kind of smears and public attacks happen on us whenever we're getting close to the truth about the criminals operating right in the system that we fund, that we support. And so I would say to people, now is the time to come out even more boldly. It's those criminals that have their backs against the wall. They have to be careful, not us. We have the evidence and the truth on our side, and we're going to keep pressing on this.
Well, thank you. And we certainly want to thank you for taking time out today to be with us. And we look forward to your coming again as events develop.
Thank you, Alfred. We'll keep you posted.
Thank you very much.